You've done us a great kindness, Inquisitor. Thank you. Inquisitor. Sarah, I'm sorry.
Who's what now?
My family is nobility. I've been in Seeker training since I was 6. I walked with the Divine. I've never considered what I must look like to someone common. I must indeed seem terrifying.
Nah, you're all right. Skip the someone common bit, though. Makes you seem a bit of a shit.
I have only one question, Sarah. Did you cut your own hair?
Yeah, why wouldn't I?
You could try using something other than a rusty button.
Oh, excuse me while I do got my diamond-studded hair-cutting whatevers.
Scissors. The word you're looking for is scissors.
Nothing to report, sir.
Monsieur.
Inquisitor. Inquisitor. Ferelden has faced enough darkspawn for a lifetime. 10 years passed, and you can still see how the Blight haunts this country and its people. That Herlock will put up a fight. Stand ready. We are victorious once more.
get away from the water, I'm feeling seasick already.
So you spend a lot of time around dead people? Corpses?
As Navarans, we pay respect to the departed in family crypts.
Pay respect? Like, pose them, dress them up and such?
Not in the way you're picturing.
It sounds like a big dead dollhouse. Dollhouses are creepy enough.
Well, now you know. Thank you. to report, sir.
The order was sent?
This morning.
Thank you.
right.
Inquisitor. Inquisitor.
That got a little heated. You all right?
Well, that depends. How angry is Cassandra? I wasn't trying to keep secrets. I told the Inquisition everything that seemed important at the time.
I bet Cassandra regrets how things went back there. You should talk to her.
I appreciate that you're trying to keep the peace, but things between me and the Seeker are as good as they'll get. I keep hoping none of this is real. Maybe it's all some bullshit from the Fade and it'll just disappear. I know I need to do better. I'm sorry. Corypheus is back. Oh, shit.
You said he was a darkspawn or a magister. What is he really?
I'm not sure. I don't think Corypheus really knows either. He's definitely a darkspawn, but when we found him, it was pretty obvious he hadn't heard that. He thinks he's a magister, a priest of Dumat, in fact. He says he broke into the Golden City, like in the Chantry tale.
If you and Hawk defeated him once, we can do it again.
We didn't just think Corypheus was dead. He was dead. No pulse, no breath, full of stab wounds. There wasn't a lot of room for doubt. It makes me wonder. I thought the Wardens imprisoned Corypheus to use him. Maybe they did it because he can't be killed.
How did you and Hawk even wind up in a Grey Warden prison for ancient Darkspawn?
Corypheus sent people after Hawk. He actually got control of an entire Carta clan. Made them drink darkspawn blood. Weird shit. We tracked the Carta to an old dwarven fort or something in the mountains. Of course, it turned out to be a trap. They needed Hawk's blood to open the locks holding Corypheus, and they drew us into the prison to get it.
There has to be a way to defeat Corypheus. We'll find it, don't worry.
I hope you're right. Maker's Breath, what have I let loose?
You had nothing to do with this, Varric.
I was the one who led Hawk to Corypheus. If I hadn't tracked the Carta to that ruin. But you've got more important things to do than listen to me worry. Just let me know when you want something shot. Need something?
I want to know more about Red Lyrian.
I'll tell you what I can.
What could the Templars want with it?
In Kirkwall, just having the Lyrium idol made Knight Commander Meredith impossibly strong. Before it turned her into a Lyrium statue, anyway. Maybe they thought the power was worth it, or maybe they didn't know the consequences.
I think that's enough on Red Lyrian.
Yeah, not really my favorite subject. Need something?
I want to know more about Red Lyrian.
I'll tell you what I can.
I've seen it infect people like a disease and turn them to Lyrian. How can it do that?
That's a good question. To tell the truth, we don't really know what that shit can do to a person, and I don't want to find out.
I think that's enough on Red Lyrian.
Yeah, not really my favorite subject. Need something?
Can I ask you something, Varric?
You want to talk about me? I'm flattered. Also inclined toward extravagant lies.
Thanks, Varric.
No problem. Need something?
What can you tell me about this Corypheus?
I'm not exactly an expert, but ask away and I'll answer what I can.
How did you first encounter him?
A few years back, I was dealing with some trouble from a Carta clan that went rogue. They were sending assassins after the Hawk family. We tracked them to a rune in the Vimarks. It turned out to be a trap. Once you went far enough into the rune, there was a magic barrier that kept you from going back. The whole thing was a prison the Grey Wardens were using to hold what they thought was a powerful darkspawn.
I've never heard of Wardens locking up darkspawn. Why wouldn't they just kill him and be done with it?
I don't think they could. From what we saw in there, Corypheus can control Wardens somehow. They couldn't attack him. The Wardens locked him up because there was nothing else they could do.
He looks like some sort of blighted creature, but he speaks. What is he exactly?
The Wardens who imprisoned him thought he was just a darkspawn. But you heard him ranting. He claims he's a Magister. One who assaulted the Golden City, what, more than 1,000 years ago? It seems crazy, but if he's telling the truth, he's one of the people who caused the Blights.
You and Hawk both said before he was supposed to be dead.
He was dead. We killed him. The only way for us to escape the prison Corypheus was trapped in was to go through him. We weren't going to just leave the door to his prison open behind us and hope he was dead. We made sure.
All right, I think that's enough about Corypheus.
No problem.
You've made such intriguing design choices for the castle, my dear. They must be inspired.
Thank you, Vivian. I'm glad you approve.
When things have settled down a bit, I will take you to Valroyo and introduce you to my seamstress. And appearances are important. We can't have you mistaken for a commoner.
I've never been much concerned with maintaining the distinction of rank.
It's not about rank, darling. It's about power. You command an army of the faithful, outfitted by the coin of the nobility. You must be a man who the common folk aspire to be and to whom the nobility bow.
And you think I can accomplish this purely through fashion?
It is a weapon in your arsenal. Don't overlook it, my dear. As the stories of the Inquisition spread, more and more people will wonder if you are the man they say you are. They will question what they've heard, but they will believe what they see. They must see someone greater than legends.
If that's your standard for me, what does the Divine have to live up to?
Andraste and the Maker cast very large shadows. The Divine absolutely must set the example for all Thedas. She must seem to be the embodiment of the Maker to the faithful. She needs the authority of the Maker and the charisma of Andraste. It will be no small task to fill that vacant throne. I always have time for you, my dear.
I wanted to ask you about the Circle of Magi.
Of course. What do you wish to know? Here it is.
What is your evaluation of how we're doing?
Adequate. Based on a partial improvement to Skyhold.
As you were?
Yes, Inquisitor.
Anything interesting?
A letter regarding Felix, Alexius's son. He went to the Magisterium, stood on the Senate floor and told them of you. A glowing testimonial, I'm informed. No news on the reaction, but everyone back home is talking. Felix always was as good as his word.
Was?
He's dead. The Blight caught up with him.
Are you all right?
He was ill, and thus on borrowed time anyhow.
That doesn't mean you can't regret his death.
I know. Felix used to sneak me treats from the kitchens when I was working late in his father's study. Don't get into trouble on my behalf, I'd tell him. I like trouble, he'd say. Tevinter could use more mages like him. Those who put the good of others above themselves.
With the two of you...
Felix and I? What an odd question. No. I had no intention of abusing Alexius's hospitality by seducing his son. Not that I've been proper my whole life, by any means. It wasn't like that. Even in illness, Felix was the best of us. With him around, you knew things could be better.
You make it sound like he was a better person than you.
What a mad thing to say. Few people are better than I. Very well, a better person, clearly, not nearly as handsome. Thankfully, Felix wasn't the only decent sort kicking around Thedas. You made Alexius tranquil. I wish you'd just killed him. He was a decent man once. He deserved to keep his dignity. I hope I don't run into him. That would be more than I could handle.
I should go.
I do rather like watching you leave. Something you need?
I should go.
As you wish.
I heard of your verdict on Alexius, Inquisitor. It was all he deserved. I hope it serves as a warning for anyone, Magister or no, who thinks of trying that again.
You're not still the Grand Enchanter, then?
Any claim I had to the title ended along with the Circles of Magi, although some still call me by it. Perhaps the Circles will one day be resurrected. If so, another will take the position. Until that time, I lead my fellow mages by default. I will do what I can for them.
You believe they'll recreate the Circle of Magi after all this?
It depends on who the next Divine is, and what she offers. We can't go back to the way things were. But endless warfare benefits no one. That is why I agreed to Justinia's conclave. There must be another solution.
You were once a Grey Warden.
Mine is an unusual circumstance, Inquisitor. Normally one is part of the Order until death. But long ago I found myself stripped of what made me a Warden. They tried to reinitiate me, but nothing worked. Nor could they figure out how it happened. So I was sent to the Circle of Magi, the first Warden ever to be kicked out. Quite the achievement.
You sound happy about it.
Becoming a Warden seemed like a dream when I was first conscripted. Towards the end, however, my brothers and sisters, they felt I had somehow cheated death. I was glad to leave. It also made me unique in the Circle. I had an opportunity to do more than I ever could as a Warden.
You mean you began the Mage Rebellion?
I pushed for our vote to free the Circles of Magi. But I cannot claim sole responsibility for what followed. Still, despite all the chaos, I would do it again. What happened had to happen.
I trust everything is well with the mages.
Some struggle with the idea we are once again subject to control, but we are enduring.
I'll leave you to it.